Crufts is undoubtedly more a show for the owners than their pampered pets. This year, around 15,000 four-legged hopefuls will strut past the judges, but not before the ritual wash and brush up.
Well, she's been in the car since 6:30 this morning. She loves every minute of it, so it's worth it.
But the waiting's too much for some. But when the big moment finally arrives, it's a completely different story. And all that training certainly paid off for this two-year-old Dalmatian called Jason and his patient owner.
He hasn't been in the ring for quite a long while, and it was we waited for him to mature, and now he's matured, he's come out and won.
He doesn't look very interested now, just think now the excitement's all over.
I think he's a bit tired, he's had a long day. He had to get up at 3:00 this morning, and that's it's a long while for him.
Today the obedience tests are continuing, but tomorrow Crufts will see a first. It will be the first terrier race around this main ring. They'll be chasing a furry-looking object, which is supposed to be a ferret or a rat. And the first across the post wins a silver salver.
There's quite a lot of terrier racing in the north of the country, and we just thought we'd try it for a demonstration.
Now, will people be allowed to place bets on the likely winner?
No, not officially. What they do unofficially, it's a different matter.
This is the last time Crufts will be held in London. Next year, the show's off to Birmingham. Deborah Bain with the Pampered Pooches for Thames News.